Rexy is showing off the merch.
Yeah, what up? Snoop.
Yo, it's D again. It's October 16th, 2022 at Mohawk GP in Landsborough, Mass, J-Day Off-Road. This is Avet A Senior Moto number 2. That fire truck over there was pretty cool, converted into a moto van. I thought I'd show that. But here's the start for Moto 2. We're gonna do a lap with me on board, and I'm pretty embarrassed about this because I restarted my bike and right before the flag went, so that's why I got such a bad start. I had to shut down and start again, but my friend Chad to the left of me did the same. And I think I got a bad start, but you the judge. I need to be more aggressive in this area of the race, and I think I'll be able to hold a better position if I can pull through on that area. But this is the first wood section. Everybody got funneled up here again. Some trees that people almost went into, or I go around, do this left hand. The track's pretty beat now. All these inside ruts have huge holes in them. So during my track walk, I was talking about going to the outside of the grass drags coming up. We'll see how that fends for me right now as we're going into that section. So I'm going out wide here to get on the inside here. I should have went inside, but this section I wanted to go out wide at the end and power down the whole straightaway is what I was trying to do, and I think it worked out for me. We got a good head of speed here, so caught up to this fella. I'm just trying to be consistent, trying to not go down. The track got really rough, a lot of braking bumps there. This right-hander uphill kind of a thing. Going inside on this mound kind of could make and break. You could lose time, gain time. Looks like it was pretty equal. This was real choppy. The ruts had a lot of rocks in it. If I didn't have a bib moose, I guarantee you I'd have a rear flat. Going wide here, trying to charge up this hill more on the inside, staying away from the roost. This was real acceleration bumps, like bumpy and choppy. Then this section kind of was the same as first moto. If you watch the first moto, this kind of replicates it. I got seventh in this moto as well, so I did a 7 overall for the day, which I'm pretty excited about. It's one of my better finishes, and it shows a little progress. I had to take a different line here because I wanted to make a pass stick. Was able to do so barely, but this flat track off-camera stuff I was struggling on today big time. But I was trying to go outside. My friend and I, Clint, were talking about this, and then going down the start straight again, wide open as fast as you can. This bridge on the left hand was real slippery. Like I had to let off the gas, otherwise the tire was spinning. Going up this gradual hill again, this outside line was preferred for me. I felt more comfortable just lugging, so I went inside this one. Sorry. This line was not bad. There was a route here you could jump over all that if you had the speed. It was not bad, but I felt more comfortable on that outside line. Made a couple line changes after reviewing some footage in between motos, and going outside on some of these lines was better off. This was a good one, missing mud. I gotta get more aggressive on the straights like this. Yeah, this is the second section of the woods. There's like cart roads like this, which was fun. Had a lot of fun today. I know I'm very repetitive with my videos, but this is just, it is what it is. This is on board lap at the Mohawk GP, round 13 in the J-Day Off-Road. So this line that I just took was probably my worst line. I shouldn't have took that. A lot of people passed me there, like right here, I think. Yeah, I got all messed up. I think a couple people get me. Yeah, see, there's one, two. Now I gotta pass these people back or try. That was a big concrete piece in the middle of the woods. And yeah, so I'm trying to get to this downhill section that people were super loose on, myself included. A lot of veiny roots coming up. You can see all those white lines. Those are very slippery roots. You hit those and you just slide out. It's crazy, but traction was definitely an issue. Not much positive traction at this race today. Still was fun though. It was not an aggressive race. I know I can turn it up. I gotta focus on that. Tips for today that I was focusing on. I was trying to weight the outside peg for traction, but once you're over stuff like this, it's like slippery. You gotta kind of put both feet out, go for it, and hopefully you don't slide out. All about forward momentum today, I want to say. Like on sections like this, if you stop too much, you're gonna slide. So you kind of gotta like pick your line and go forward. Like in this area, give it gas. Then you're coming down to this downhill. You have to like between these two trees, just commit to it. And I was using this line this time around, was better for me. We talked about this in between motos, and this is the line that Bowden wanted me to take. That's Chad's son, his oldest son, Bowden. If he's watching this, he'll like that I took the line he recommended or requested. That was like a killer line. And then I was going outside. I should have stuck to the right, but I had a better chance on these rocks. They were at an angle if I went the other line. Then the extreme section I was not nervous about. I was kind of attacking this a little more than I usually do. I'm gaining a little speed on the fella in front of me. Not typically my forte. Today was not bad. Then you got the choker lane. You could have went left, right. I used the left. I went inside to inside. See what I did here? Way less effort going on the inside. You just had to hairpin it. Then pin this line before the checkpoint. I was on this fella. I was trying to get around him. And that's the goal. It's a race. Let's go. You gotta get past people and move on. Wide open here again. This is the actual start straight. And that is one lap at the Mohawk GP in Landsborough, Mass. Great track. The facility was great. Too bad it was like on a cornfield and you're tripping on all the corn stems or whatever, the roots, but it was good. I'm surprised they like clear a spot like that, like they like park on it and stuff. From what I understand, last year it was so much rain that people would get stuck in the cornfield, like in the mud. They couldn't leave, but all is well. There's Ryan again. My buddy Ryan just eating us up for breakfast, showing us how it's done from a minute behind. And yeah, just a couple more Junior B guys coming up that can get in the way. This fella, I try not to get in the way, but I'm racing a race as well. They gotta understand that. Junior B should probably be in front of us taking off first, but whatevs. Like and subscribe to the channel. Continue to watch the moto. It's a full moto if you'd like. Yeah, all right. Well, that's all I got for you. I'll catch you at the next. I'm going to do some practice at a motocross track this week, maybe some trails this weekend. Then we'll do some GoPro of the next race. I'll catch you at the next. Later.